All right, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Wow. Hello, it is Friday, right? Friday, and it's time for our business planning call. And as I pull up the presentation, I'm going to ask my fellow district managers to start with some introductions.
Hello, everyone. This is Tyra, the district sales manager for District 1605 and District 1581. We're very glad to have you today, and we hope that you take some of this information today back to your business and continue to grow.
Hi, everybody. My name is Christy Springer, and I'm the district manager for 4684. And 4733, and I am so excited. I love these Friday calls. I just think everyone gets so much out of them. So I'm very excited for today.
And I'm Robin. I'm 1612, 1481, and I'm so excited. I see some of our new people on here. So yay, thank you for joining. We're really glad you joined us today.
Yay, yay. And I'm Dee Thornton, and I'm from three districts, District 4686, 4712, and 4693. So we are excited to spend the next happy hour with you all. And hey, TGIF, thank God it is Friday. And we hope that this is one of the happiest hours of your day. Okay, because we're going to be sharing some exciting news about your business. We're going to give you some ideas. And when you leave this call, you're going to be really happy that you are an Avon Beauty Boss, right? Now, these calls are recorded because we realize that everyone can't join us at 1 o'clock on a Friday afternoon. So they are recorded. We like to give you that disclaimer up front. So that if you are on camera, when someone reviews the recording, they will be able to see you. And if you do not want that to occur, all you have to do is just turn your little camera off, okay? But we do want to make sure that you do know that it will be shared. But we love, love, love to see your smiling faces. And, you know, you've got the chat box. We like to get that going. Several managers are going to be watching the chat box, answering questions. So don't hesitate to speak up. You can type right in the chat box and ask any question that you would like. All right, so let's get this started. Happy hour, your happiest hour of the day. Now, hey, these calls are twice a month on a Friday, and it's really all about the boss life with Avon. Each call has a very similar format. and a consistent agenda. You know, we always talk about goals. We always talk about our calendars and campaign planning, sales and customers. We give you valuable selling tips, talk about key products, give you some ideas on how to prospect and grow new customers and grow your sales. And we always leave you with the next steps. Now, when we start these calls, we ask that you have a few things right there in front of you. We hope that you have your cell phone available because you might want to look to that cell phone and text a message to one of your friends or customers and let them know about something exciting that you just heard about. And my fellow district managers can teach you how to take a picture and send a text and share your love of Avon. You know, you also would want to have your customer list in front of you. You've got a list of all of the people who have ever made a purchase from you, or maybe your list is that list of people that you look to asking them to be one of your customers. Have a pen and paper with you always, a calendar. Anyone that's running a business must have a calendar putting down those important dates. And I would say have a campaign 8 and a campaign 9 brochure in front of you, and a campaign 10 and or 9 and 10, what's new. So if you don't have these things in front of you, take some time, get them so that you're prepared to make the most of the next hour together. Now, as always, we start with a little discussion on goals. And we do this because goals must be written down, read, reread, and shared. And we always ask you to have your 4 goals. Now, some of you may type in the chat box as I'm speaking. Share with us 1 or 2 of your goals. You know, we want to know what your goals are so that we can help you achieve them. And when you read them, reread them, share them, type them, look at them, and repeat them, though that repetition leads to change. You know, I was listening to a video the other day of one of the Shark Tanks. I don't know if you guys watch Shark Tank, but one of the Shark Tanks was talking about how he really got started and how he got to be, you know, this multi-millionaire. And he said, when I was starting out, and this was the one who is in the clothing business. Oh gosh, can't even think of his name right now. He's in the clothing business. He started out with FUBU was his clothing line. And he said, I started out with a goal. And he said, I wrote that goal down and I read that goal every day. That was the first thing I did when I woke up in the morning because it kept me focused. So, you know, we've been, most of the district managers have been reading a book called Outliers by Malcolm Gladwell. And it really talks about what makes people successful. And one of the things that makes them successful is that they are very goal-oriented. They write it down and they look at it each and every day as a reminder. And then they think about, wow, when I achieve this goal, how will it make me feel? When I achieve it, how will it make me feel? You know, I exercise. I'm an exercise person and my goal is to exercise every day. And it's really easy to exercise every day when you make your goal manageable. So guess what? I do a 10-minute workout, 10 minutes. Now, in the course of a 12-hour day, if I don't have 10 minutes to work out, I feel like I'm a loser. But when I get that 10 minutes done in the morning, or maybe it's during lunch, or maybe it's right before I go to bed, I can tell you I feel fabulous. Then you have to think about, does your behavior match your goals? So that was a prime example. If my goal is to exercise and if my behavior shows that I'm exercising, then yes, my behavior matches my goals. So we're excited that each and every one of you are on this call because we know one of your goals must be to improve your Avon business. And so to improve your Avon business, your behavior today is joining this 1 hour call to learn something new about your business, to get an idea or a suggestion that'll help you get new customers and grow your sales. Now, at the bottom of this screen, we got a list. We got 4 different goals listed here. These are just kind of goals that we would suggest. They don't have to be yours, but you know, some of them are business-related goals. Some of them are personal-related goals. Some of yours may be family-related, spiritual. It could be a variety of things. Whatever it is, put it down, write it down, read it, reread it, and share it. Anybody sharing any goals in the chat? All right. Well, we'll hear about them, I'm sure. Now, this is all about planning. Put on your calendars our next two business planning calls for the month of April. They are April the 7th and April the 21st. Again, they're at 1 o'clock. But the good news is that we record these calls. So if you can't make the next call at 1 o'clock, no worries. We're going to send you out a replay and you can listen to it at your convenience, all right? So those are the next business planning dates that you should have on your calendar. And as always, you will have on your calendar when your campaign 8 order goes in, your campaign 9, 10, 11, 12, going to list them out for the entire year. Put your vacations on there, your birthdays, your anniversaries, birthdays, anniversaries of other family members. These become opportunities for you to sell your Avon business and offer gifts for those friends and family, and also your customers. Wouldn't it be nice for you to call your customer and say, hey, I know your husband's birthday's coming up. Hey, we've got a great new fragrance coming. So always, always, always use your calendar. You know, if you don't have one, you can probably still run out and get a 2017 calendar in your office supply or the Dollar Tree. Now, here, we're talking about President's Club. How about Robin? Are you there?
I'm here.
Hey, can you talk a little bit about President's Club and Rep Fest and just cover this slide with our listeners?
So we all know how exciting it is when we do the galas. And if you're new, and I have some new ones on here, President's Club is something we've really been talking about as a goal that you want to put down because it's going to guarantee you the earnings, the 40% earnings. So, and it has all kinds of perks. Not only is it a prestigious club, it's a way to increase your business. So you want to make sure President's Club is definitely one of your goals. Now, we've talked about you have to have 10,000 in sales, and some of you are like, holy cow, 10,000 in sales? Well, no, not really. It's not a lot when you break it down like Dee has for you every time we've been on this call. Look at all the things that you get. 40% earnings guaranteed, 25% on fixed earnings. You can order more demo products out of the What's New, which is awesome for your business. I know people at the end of the year, they take those points that they get, and that's what they do their Christmas shopping for. Miss Albie is something that you can get with your points. So there's so many things that you can get by being in President's Club. It's definitely something that you have got to put down as a goal for your business. Now, as far as Rep Fest goes, everybody needs to be at Rep Fest. Why? Because they treated us like we were on the red carpet last year. I have never, ever been to anything so amazing in my life. And I'm not just saying that. We have been to a lot of meetings. We've been to Rep Fest before, but this was immaculate. We had ballerinas coming from the ceilings. They treated you like gold. You get the swag bag. So it's something that you have got to sign up for now because it's $99. It's going back up as of March 31st. So time is running out and we want you all to be there. It's so much fun. You get to meet other representatives who are just starting, who have been tenure with the company. You learn so much. And the big thing is you're going to learn about products that's not even been out yet. So our health and wellness, and you get perks by coming because you'll be able to sell them first. So you'll be the first ones that will be able to offer the products. So go on that link after this call and sign up today because spaces are limited. We're running out of spaces and we want you there.
Awesome, awesome. Rep Fest is going to be awesome. Now, on these calls, we talk about customers. And we really ask you to bring your customer list to this call, existing customers, or even a potential list of customers to this call. And we ask you to type into the chat box how many customers you have. Share with us how many you have, whether it's 1, 2, 10, 20, 100. Let us know how many customers you have. And anyone, and we define a customer as anyone, absolutely anyone who has made a purchase from you. And then we'd like for you to ask or answer these questions. Do you have their name and phone number? And that's their home number or their cell number. Do you have their email address? And do you have their physical address? And then what do you know about them? What do you know about your customers? And how do you communicate with them? How do you stay in contact with them? Okay. Are we getting any responses in the chat on the number of customers?
We do, Dee. We have 16. We have 4 right now. So I love that positive attitude. And 22. Oh, here's another person that said 40. So we've got an entire mix of amount of customers.
Awesome. Awesome. That's great. You know, and so think about the questions that we've posed to you on this particular slide as you look at all of the customers that you have. And then later on in this call, we're going to talk about how you can grow your customers and your sales right from your existing customer base, okay? Right, just by knowing who they are, what they like, and really kind of analyzing what they buy from you. Now, we're going to flip into some selling tips. And two weeks ago, we spent some time talking about an Avon book party. And we thought on this call we would revisit that only to see if there was any questions about an Avon book party, to again clarify and highlight how they're done, and to offer some suggestions to you as to how this could be an awesome, awesome way for you to grow your business. Now, I'm going to call on one of my fellow district managers to see if she'll want to take the Avon book party review. Christy, are you out there?
I am.
You are. Good deal. Well, hey, I'm going to let you kind of do the high-level overview of book parties. And, you know, we always start out with saying, you know, why in the world do you do a book party anyway?
Right. Absolutely. Well, first, while I'm talking, if anyone can type in the chat, maybe you were on the call last time and you've had a book party, or you have a question about having a book party, or you're new and just want to know exactly what the book party is. You know, if you can go ahead and type that in the chat so we can make sure that we answer any questions you have. And, you know, an Avon book party, I'm sure, you know, many of you have been to some kind of hostess party, right? And direct selling. It's number one, it's a way for you to really get your name out there, right? And to promote, you know, your new business, which is Avon. Two, it can really help you increase your sales, right? Because it's a way within, you know, whether it's a 3-hour book party or a 3-day book party, right? It's a way to really generate some great revenue for your business. Number three, and most importantly, it's a great way for you to find customers, right? Without maybe, you know, having to, you know, walk the mall like, you know, people used to do in the past, which, you know, we still do. We, as Avon people, we always have our Avon buttons on and we always have the brochures with us, but it's just a very simple way for you to have people that are so excited about Avon either in one place or under one book party, right? So, you know, you might ask, how do I get started with this? And I'm sorry, Dee, do we have like any slides? There we go. You know, how do we get started with this? Well, the first, and I think the most important, is you have to find your hostess, right? So if you're coming to me and let's say you're selling, I don't want to, you know, say the name, but let's say you're selling fragrances and I'm someone that I don't even like fragrance, right? How effective is it going to be for me to have a party for you? Probably not very effective. But for me, if I love Avon and you're going to tell me, gosh, you know what? I have a way for you to be able to get your Avon maybe $100 off. Or for me, maybe it could be my whole campaign is going to be free, right? Now I am excited. And who are the people that we know consistently order from us every campaign, right? It's our own customers. So that's why this is such a simple process, because all you're doing is finding your host and they're right there with the numbers you just gave us, guys. So whether you have four customers or you have 40 customers, you have your hostess right there, because who would want to have a book party? I'm going to be able to get the products that I already love for free, right? So that's our first thing, is we have to find a hostess. Like you can see, you can give them a brochure, right? And they can order on it, or they can shop for their $100 in free products. And that's what I love to do, right? Tell them by having a $500 book party, they're going to be able to earn $100 in free product for themselves. So go ahead and get them excited. You know, if they love Avon Living, tell them, hey, here's the current brochure. Go ahead and pick out $100 in products, because I know it's going to be so easy for you to have that $500 host party. Then you want to give them a party pack, right? And a gift for doing it, right? Because if they do it once, and they're going to get free products, they're probably going to want to do it again, right? And you can allow them to have anywhere from 7 days. I wouldn't go any farther than that, because, of course, urgency is really, you know, what gets everyone excited about this. So, you know, give them up to 7 days to get orders from friends and family. And we have this question I know pop up last time. How do I know if they order from my e-store? All you have to do is have the hostess give you your name, right? And then you're going to be able to know if she ordered off of your e-store. Keep a list of everyone. You're going to want to complete order forms for everyone's purchase. And then, like we've already talked about, go ahead and offer your e-store address. So second is you're going to collect orders and payments. So, of course, you want to make sure they have to pay at the time that they place their order, right? So your hostess is going to collect all of the orders for you and then, of course, tell you how much. So here's the other thing that, you know, I know Dee thought of, and to be quite honest, I didn't even think of it. So, you know, she thought of this and I thought that it was brilliant. So let's say you have three people from the hostess party that placed over a $40 order. How easy is that? You can just order it through your e-store, right? Because number one, it's going to be free shipping. But number two, they're going to get it really fast. So probably in under 3 days. And they're going to be able to get a brochure with their orders, right? And then just with all the other orders, go ahead and place them just like you regularly do through your Avon.com. But here's the big thing. So let's say that Dee's my hostess, and by gosh, she wanted to make sure she earned $100 in free products. So let's say she had a $500 hostess party. So when I submit my orders, not only do I submit those, but I put in Dee's $100 order too, right? So now really, your $500 book party turned into a $600 book party. That's how you're going to be able to give her that $100 in free orders. So really important. You always want to make sure you include the host order as well. Number four is how do you deliver them? And, you know, we've talked about this. You know, if, you know, this is someone that's all her friends and family, maybe you want to have them all come back to, you know, her house that it was, or maybe a meeting place, a Starbucks or whatever, and have it really fun. You know, deliver all their products to them, get them excited, because that's your chance to also ask for a referral for the next book party, right? So, oh my gosh, I'm so glad that you love your products. Now, who can tell me who wants to have the next Avon Hostess party and get your $100 in free products? And make sure that you also write a little thank you note, right? We don't get those very much anymore with all the new technology. So a handwritten thank you note goes a long way. And then again, make sure you have that list, right? Because if they were so excited to place an order, that could be, you know, your next customer as well. So you want to make sure that you also have their names so that you can follow up. And remember, guys, you know, you could have two parties every campaign. You could have a party every campaign. I know Dee and I were talking the other night and we're like, gosh, if I'm someone that I love Avon and you're telling me just by having a $500 party, I can get $100 in free Avon, I might want to do that every campaign. So just think, by me, one person, helping you have a $500 party every campaign, where is that going to actually put you every campaign, right? Because $380 is going to get you over and get you going towards that President's Club that Robin talked about before. So this can really add up. And I know we've got a lot of people, and they're even having more than one Hostess party every campaign. So, and then as you can see on here, you know, Dee put together, you know, what do you offer your hostess? So again, you know, here's what you say. You know, you definitely want him to have at least $100 in sales, right? And that's going to be $20 in free products. And you can see going all the way down up to $500 in sales is going to get them $100 in free products. So very, very exciting. So does anyone have any questions on that? Okay. All right. And then just to finish up, how does your hostess get their free products, right? So again, let's go through an example again. The party is a $400 party, right? She gets her friends and family to order. That means she's going to earn 20% or $80 in free products. So again, like we talked about before, when you place your order through Avon.com, not only are you placing the $400 order, you're also placing her $80 order for her free products. That's going to earn you 40% or $192. So after you give your hostess her $80, right, in free products, you've still earned $112. And like we've been talking about, gained all of those new customers that I'm sure are going to be the next in line to have the next hostess party for you. So very exciting.
Awesome. Awesome. Thanks. Thanks, Christy. So, you know, let's go prospecting. Let's go looking for some new customers. So we're going to play a little game, and all of my fellow district managers are going to be on the call, and we're just going to go look for some new customers, or we're going to see how we can drive a higher level of satisfaction with our existing customers. So let's talk about customers. So we have a campaign 8 cover brochure here to the left. And in campaign 8, let's just say we have 7 customers. And we've given a description of each one of these customers. So I'd ask any and everyone who's on the call, if you want to take your phone off of mute, and I think I have most, take your phone off mute if it's not, or I can unmute everyone, but at least have all of the district managers off of mute, because we're going to talk about these 7 customers. And we're going to think creatively about how we might drive a few things. One, how could we make this customer feel more appreciated and drive a higher level of customer satisfaction? how can we grow our sales, or how can we get new customers? So let's start with customer number one. Customer number one is a new customer for you in campaign A. She likes to shop online, and her total order in campaign eight was $35. Now, who can give me one or two things you might want to do with this customer?
Hey Dee, this is Tyra. So the first thing, you would want to reach out to this customer and try to get her to increase her order size to $40, because we know normally on the e-store, we do run a special frequently where if it's at least $40, they'll receive free shipping. But right now in campaign eight, like you're talking about, customers, what they will find a special offer on the e-store where it's a minimum of a $40 purchase. They're going to receive an Avon True Color package, which has mascara and a couple of products there. So she's going to appreciate that as a customer who loves to shop online, because she is actually going to possibly get the free shipping. Plus right now we have a special offer, so she can actually get more products for the price really that she was willing to pay for just a few items that she had purchased.
Awesome. Great, great ideas. And you know, it sounds like Tyra, you determined that simply because you knew that the customer liked to shop online, right? You knew that about her. Awesome. Customer number two, she's a current customer. She's bought from you before. She likes makeup, and her total order is $25. What's something you might want to say or do for her?
Well, Dee, I guess I'll go again. but if I have a current customer who really likes makeup and her total order is $25, you know, we know as an Avon representative, normally an average customer order is $25 to $30. But here's the thing. You always want to broaden your product line with the customer. And, you know, if she likes the makeup products, it may be foundation. Well, how about adding a cheek color to that? Or how about a lipstick? So that you're broadening her scope of our products, and she gets turned on to another type of product that she likes, and then she becomes a repeat customer for more than one item.
Awesome. Great idea. Great idea. So let's go to customer number three. Customer number three, she's also a current customer. She's ordered from you before. She loves, loves, loves Avon, and her total order is $60.
I'll take it. So because she's a current customer, we always want to make sure that we keep some type of index cards or something about what they love. So I'm going to thank her for her purchase, and I'm also going to let her know that the new product that she loves is on sale in this brochure, and it would be a great time for her to add that product. So keeping track of what your customers like, when they've ordered it, a customer history. Some people keep it on their phone. Some people keep it on index cards. But letting her know the product that she loves is on sale in that brochure always will generate an add-on.
Awesome. Awesome. Great ideas, Robin. Hey, let's look at customer number four. She's a new customer. She loves jewelry, fragrance, makeup, and her total order was $70. Anybody got any ideas for her?
Well, she's got a big order, so I'm definitely going to thank her. And then I'm going to tell her how excited I am to be her Avon representative. And does she know anybody that might be interested in Avon? So I'm going to ask her for referrals is probably what I would do with the new customer.
Awesome. Awesome. Ask her for referrals. Awesome. Customer number five, she's a current customer. She's been ordering from you in the past. She loves our personal care items. She's an older lady, and her total order is $25. Any ideas for her?
I think with Okay, Tara, you're going to have to come on.
And where's Christy?
Where's Christy?
Here's what I was going to say for an older customer, and she really likes her personal care items too. We have to be considerate of those that, you know, may not have the ability to get out to the local retail chain. And what can we, as an Avon representative, provide to them to, you know, like this lady, taking care of her personal needs. So it's a one-stop shop. And, you know, some people just like, that may be the only person that she sees within a 2-week time frame, right? So providing her that personal, you know, touch by delivering her products. But, you know, she may have never thought about this. She may just think of Avon, hey, this is where I get my personal care items. But you got to think, if she has limited access to go outside maybe her home or to the retail, she can also have that ability to purchase products for maybe her grandkids, for her children as well, to through Avon, so that, you know, if a birthday comes up or an anniversary, she doesn't have to worry about getting to a local retail chain. She can just shop through her local Avon representative. And, you know, obviously that's increasing your order as a representative. And, you know, there's going to be probably a lot of birthdays and a lot of anniversaries and things that she wants to buy special gifts for.
Awesome. Awesome. All great ideas. And you're absolutely correct. And just as you said, Tyra, she's an older lady. She may not get out, but she probably has family. So, you know, ask her about her family, ask her about her daughter or son. You know, those two may be referral opportunities for you to also pick up additional customers. So let's look at customer number 6. She's a new customer. Very similar to customer number 4. You know, jewelry, fragrance, makeup, she loves Avon, it looks like, and she orders a variety of products. Her total order is $60. So that's a pretty big order. You know, with her, some of the things that have already been shared would apply. She may be a customer, along with customer number 4, where you might want to ask her if she'd like to have a party, a book party. Maybe she'd like to earn free product. So, you know, remember that that's always an option for you to offer that, to see if, you know, that may be something that she might want to consider. In addition,
Dee, I'll say this, if she likes our jewelry, our fragrance, our makeup, it sounds like she likes everything, right? So I'm going to definitely, as an Avon representative, introduce her to our home living line as well, because if she's purchasing from every category, let's go ahead and get her interested in home living as well.
Absolutely. So that's one area where she's not participating. And right. She, you know, so often people forget about that brochure. So great catch, Tyra. And our last customer, customer number 7, she's a current customer. She loves Avon. Skincare is one of her things. And with that, she loves makeup, and she happens to work with the PTO, the Parent Teacher Organization, and her total order is $80.
Oh, I'm going to be talking to her about a fundraiser, definitely, because as we all know, as Avon representatives, you know, we can approach, I mean, if we have a customer that's in the PTA, I think is what you were saying, mm-hmm. We would talk to her about possibly getting into that, to that school, possibly her, you know, helping out to get a fundraiser register, because as a Avon representative, you're going to earn 50%. But if that customer can get you in and develop a fundraiser, guess what? You can give them, you know, some type of little special gift for doing so.
Awesome. Awesome. You know, so what we just discussed is 7 customers. And I think you guys in the chat box earlier, I mean, I didn't see all of the chats, but I think the numbers ranged from what, 5 to how many?
90. There was one that was 90. I don't know if that's
90, 40.
I mean, there were huge numbers. So I guess the message in this is do some analysis, do some planning, understand your customers, look at what they're ordering, and your new customer and the new growth of your business lies in your existing customers. Okay, they will help you build your business. But you've got to do the work. You've got to ask the questions. You've got to give them a high level of customer satisfaction. And you've got to, you know, really think about what else you might offer for them. Because we didn't talk about that on this call. But selling, whether it's Avon or anything else, is all about meeting customer needs. And what we've discussed today is all of these customers, they have needs and they have wants, and your ability to uncover those and satisfy them is really what's going to drive your business. And yet, Robin, I think you were going to make a comment.
Well, I just wanted to make sure we didn't miss the chats, because some of them are at work and they can't speak, but they're typing. So with a lot of these scenarios, they said we definitely need to make sure we share samples to increase sales, and that we always need to share the opportunity, because they can get a personal discount on their shopping if they want to start their own business. So that was a couple that was in the chat box.
Awesome. Awesome. Great. I love it. I love it. And I thank all of you for joining the call while you're working and chatting and finding a way to participate. All right. And that's a great lead in, because so often we get calls from representatives and they'll say, we'll get a text, we'll get a call. Hey, I've got someone that wants to become a part of my team. How do I sign them up? So, hey, Tyra, you want to take this one?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I've already dealt with that about two or three times today and five times yesterday, which is super exciting.
Yeah,
so it is super exciting when we have more people joining. So how does someone join your Avon team? Well, first, you're going to have that person go to www.startavon.com. And here is the little glitch. You want to make sure that they use your reference code. So once they get to that page, it's going to start asking some personal information, I guess, just standard stuff like your address, things of that nature. Then it's going to ask for a reference code. Now that's where that you come in, okay? You want to make sure that they are using your personal reference code. And as shown here, it is the last part of your e-store address. So everyone's e-store address is youravon.com/, and there's some information after the slash. The information that's there is your personal reference code. It could be your first and last name. It could be a couple of characters with a little bit of numeric. It just depends. But that's what you're going to provide to them. But guess what? It gets even better. If you don't know what your personal reference code is, not a problem. Just simply log into your Avon account. And at the very top, as we show here on the screen, to get to this circle here on your screen, you're actually going to click on Web Office. And then you want to look over on the right-hand side that you can see here, and it shows Tools to Maximize Your Business. Right underneath that is where that circle is, and it says this is your e-store address. But remember, your personal reference code is just the part after the slash. That's all they're going to do is to go to startavon.com, and when it asks for the reference code, that you will provide them your personal reference code. Now, one little thing, I want to make sure that you're earning from this as well, right? So you want to make sure that you encourage that new team member in their first or second order to place at least a $150 order. Now, if you're a new representative, you're going to get $50 in your first 90 days. And if you're a seasoned representative, when they sign up and place that size order, you're going to get $20. Okay, Dee, I think I got all that covered.
All right, sounds good. Hey, I'm not watching the chat, but hey, what happens when they do have someone new to sign up? Go ahead.
It gets even better. So not only do they get the money that I was talking about, they get a scratch-off ticket. So how amazing. You're going to get a scratch-off ticket for every person that signs up, places their first $150 order in their first or second order. So I know you're wanting to know a little bit about what's on that that scratch-off ticket. Okay, so let me tell you, it could be more. But here's the great thing about it. Every ticket is a winner. It may be Avon branded merchandise, but every single ticket is a winner. So how exciting. And here at Avon, we always say never scratch alone. So we highly encourage you when you get those tickets to record yourself and put it out on Facebook and social media, showing everyone what you've won.
Awesome. Awesome, Tyra. Hey, never scratch alone. And I tell you, we've had a lot of people scratching this past week, and there seems to be a lot of activity going on. So I am just hopeful that many of the folks on this call will be able to participate as well. Now, another area that we talk about a lot on these calls is product know-how and the $30 order. And, you know, that we have Campaign Central that you can access from your Avon.com and listen to two or three products being highlighted. So we always suggest that you go and listen to that because it's wonderful. And there's representatives just like yourselves giving their own personal testimonies. And the reason why we talk about doing $30 orders is that each campaign, you really want to get to the point that you have a $30 order and around 16 customers. Now, of course, fewer customers and higher orders will get you to that $480 campaign amount faster. But the reason why we focus on this is that at $480 every single campaign, that's the magic number to help get you to President's Club. And in addition to that, when you take that on a consistent level, and then you throw in book parties and fundraisers and all kinds of other things that we're going to share with you that you can do with your Avon business, your sales will grow and you will achieve President's Club. Okay, so that's the magic number, 16 customers times a $30 order. So we're going to talk about some products and some ways that you can grow those order sizes. And we always start with understanding your what's new. And now most people on this call are into campaign 8. Some of you may have placed a campaign 8 order. Some of you may not. Some of you haven't placed an order at all yet. And so we'd like to share with you the what's new. Now, if you're in a campaign 8, you can order from the campaign 9 and the campaign 10 what's new. That allows you to order in advance of the campaign so that you have demos and samples to share. And it also allows you to drive your profit and your earnings. And we're going to show you how that all works. Okay. So let's take a look at the what's new. In what's new 9, that's the one with the absolute fragrance on. That's the mom and the daughter and the dad on the cover. But in What's New 9, there is a 6-piece collection in there. And that 6-piece collection is $15.59. It is the Skin So Soft Aqua Express collection. It is super, super hydration. It has an awesome, awesome scent. It includes 2 body washes, 2 moisturizing gels, and 2 body sprays. You as a representative absolutely need to buy this. The question is, do you buy 1 or do you buy 2 or do you buy 3 or do you buy 10? I mean, you can buy unlimited. You can order unlimited of these. This, if you're a new representative, is an awesome way to kick off your business. There are multiple ways you can use this, but when you order this with your campaign 8 order, utilizing the order number 675901, you will get it for $15.59. It is a 6-piece collection, and then we suggest you create a wow deal. Split it into 2 3-piece collections and sell each one of them for $12.99. which is really what's going to appear in the Campaign 9 brochure. But the difference is you can create awesome Easter baskets with those 3 products. It is an awesome hostess gift for someone who might want to have a party. It is great cash and carry for you if you're doing an event. I mean, the opportunity is endless. my fellow district managers, any other suggestions you have for them on this Skin So Soft Aqua Express collection? How many are you guys going to buy?
I think you've covered it, Dee. I know that my team has definitely received it through email and Facebook today. So they're like, oh no, here we go. It's getting so soft. But I think we're just trying to put a sense of urgency around it so that we really tell them, you know, what a great offer it is and how much opportunity that there is for them to make money with their business, and perfect timing for, you know, Easter baskets, Mother's Day, all different things. Graduation's coming up. All different activities.
Awesome. Awesome. All right. So, hey, if you've got pen and paper in hand and you're looking for a way to drive increased profits with an awesome product that will really allow you to make money, you must buy this. You must buy this. All right. Now we're going to move to another one, another awesome deal. And it is also in your What's New 9. And these are great add-on sale items or gifts to help you build that $30 order. You remember we talked earlier, you had a customer that had ordered $25 from you, or a customer that had ordered, you know, $10, and maybe they hadn't really thought about Mother's Day or graduation or a birthday or an anniversary. Well, there's where these items come in handy. And I love it because Avon's given you a choice. You've got four candles in this promotion, those three wick candles. They're awesome add-on sales opportunities. They are a hosting essential at anyone. Everyone likes to walk into a house and it smells just, oh, delectable. These are four pieces. Three wick candles for $29.99, all four. These candles can stand up to anything you could get at White Barn or Bath and Body Works. Now, if you're the kind of person that doesn't like candles and you don't like burning things, because we hear that often, we have a solution for you in the home sensation, the diffuser. And I absolutely love diffusers. I have a couple of these in my home. I think they look very pretty. They're very nice for a bedroom. They're very nice for a sitting room, or, you know, a room, or right there by your front door. So when someone walks into your home, they instantly get hit with an awesome aroma. And this is a blooming jasmine diffuser. Absolutely gorgeous. And with the little petals that you can put on the ends of the stick, make it really, really nice. So these are add-on orders or gifts that you might want to consider for graduations, gifts for your hostesses, things that will help you build that $30 order. How about Robin? Robin, can you talk about the Spring Luxury Collection, which is in Campaign 8, I believe, right?
Yes, and this is something probably everyone has seen today as well. I mean, what a value. I mean, we took a picture of this. We sent it out with a text message, and we have already got responses back that they sold it. This covers everything. It's a perfect gift for, like we said, Easter baskets, Mother's Day. I know my mom loves the new product, so it's something every year that I get her, she looks forward to getting it. And it has the glamour and the lipstick and the Skin So Soft. So it's the perfect package, and you need to really push the value of this. I mean, $133 value, and they're getting it for $34.99. So if you need help with a text or what to say, those are the key words right there for these products, because these are high quality products that you're giving them for $34.99. It's an amazing deal. So take a picture when you send a text message or private message, whatever you're doing. I always show the picture. That's what's going to hook them.
Absolutely. And again, going back to our discussion of those seven customers that we talked about earlier, they're all going to appreciate you by pointing out this awesome value for only $34.99. They're going to appreciate you so much because so many of those customers like makeup, skincare, fragrance. If they only like fragrance and makeup, this is an awesome opportunity for you to expose them to a personal care item and a skincare item. Again, growing your portfolio of products that you are offering. Hey, how about this one? Campaign 8. This one is still alive and kicking, and this is the offer where with a $40 order, you can get this Wide Awake mascara set for only $5. It's a $22 value. So only $5 is all they would pay. So anyone who has placed an order with you of $40 or more, you'll want to offer this. And anyone who has not quite hit that $40 amount, you might want to suggest, hey, with an additional order getting you to $40, look what you can have absolutely free. Now, if you don't have anyone that wants to take you up on that, also know that you as a representative may want to order this in your total order so that you'll have maybe something extra. Put this in a nice little bag and use it as a hostess gift, or use it as any kind of gift to motivate and encourage or to thank your customers for doing business with you. How about this, ladies? Who's the fashionista on the phone? Tyra, Christy, Robin, who wants to take some of these?
No, I just think with Avon, we have, and, you know, Tyra, you can, you know, click in too, but I just think everyone waits for, you know, the spring, right? The new arrivals that are coming, whether that be in our purses, our tops, our shoes. And, you know, the great thing, you guys heard us saying this last year, but I know for myself, I can really say, I really think we've upped the game when it comes to our fashion now. You know, like I love the Nautica shirt that's off the shoulders. That's the big rage that you're going to see this year. I love the little drawstring, the lace up shoes. So, you know, people are waiting for this. We have people that just absolutely adore our Avon fashion. So, you know, like we've talked about before, really get to know your customers, know what they like so that they can be the first ones that you're showing our new collections to. Because as you know, right, so many people love our fashion. You want to make sure that they're getting it when the first availability is. So not to wait, you know, before it sells out. Because like with any other, you know, huge department store, right, there's only going to be a certain number, and then those items are going to be gone or they're not going to be in their size. So if you know someone that loves fashion, you know, tell them to get ready because we've really got some big contenders and great new fashions, I think, coming for the next couple campaigns.
And I agree, Christy, absolutely agree. And that's why we like to talk about the what's new. The what's new allows you to order it early, and you're ordering it at a demo price. You've got a demo price and for the first item of $14.99, or if you're a Presence Club member, it's $13.99. So it allows you to get it early at a discount. You can wear it and then sell it. People love to see a fashion and how it looks on you. So don't hesitate to be the first to order, the first to show, and the first to sell. That's how people really, really, you're a walking mannequin. You're a walking fashion show. And you'll walk out with one of these three items on, and someone definitely are going to ask, where did you get those espadrilles? Where did you get that top? Where did you get that? I think it's a kimono. Or where'd you get those shoes? Those are the questions you want to hear because that gives you an opportunity to promote your business. All right. And as Christy said, we've got some awesome, awesome fashions. All right. These are three key pieces that every Avon Fashionista needs for the spring and the summer. And I predict these items will sell out quickly. So your Avon store needs customers. Every campaign, keep thinking, 16 customers, a $30 order is $480. Now, there's one thing that we didn't mention to any of our seven customers that we talked about earlier today, and that was Avon Fashion. So that was an opportunity. We talked about Avon Living, but we didn't necessarily stress Avon Fashion. So again, analyze your existing customers and what they're buying from you so that you can offer something more and something different. Now, we've talked about this already, RepFest, August 5th through the 7th. Repetition is important. We're putting it up again. $99. It expires March 31st or when the first 6,000 registrations are achieved. You, as an Avon representative, deserve this. You deserve this break. You deserve this vacation in one of the hottest cities in the country to go and learn more about your Avon business. So we do hope that all of you will go to youravon.com and sign up today. And lastly, it's time to pick a number. It's really, really happy hour. So those of you who've been typing in the chat box, and I see there's lots of chats out there today. I haven't been reading them, but I can see the number count keep going up, 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 up. There are two lucky numbers for someone today. And while you may not get the number right on the button, whoever's closest to the two numbers will receive a gift in the mail from their district manager. So it would be helpful when you select your number that you give us your district number when we call out the winners. So I think I'm going to close out, probably getting people long enough to type it in. Is everybody okay? You think I can unveil the numbers, the winners? I see some activity still on the chat, so... All right, our winning numbers are 32 and 48. Who do we have?
Tina
Bailey guessed 32. I'm not for sure who the 48 would be. I guess maybe Dana Bailey because she guessed 33. I don't see anything higher. So I guess, Robin, is that both of yours?
Yes.
Yay! Awesome, awesome. Well, you've got two winners, and we thank them for joining the call, and we know that you're going to send them something super, super special in the mail for being the winners of today's drawing, for participating in the call. As always, we close out the call with just a quick summary, of what we've talked about. You know, again, every campaign, it's all about 16 customers and a $30 order. It's all about promoting three products every campaign. And we've talked about at least three products on this call today that you can focus on. Send texts and post on Facebook. Use your Avon Social Media Center. Connect to your district Facebook page if you haven't already. Get to know your customers better. That's one of the biggest things that I think we stressed on this call is getting to know your customers better, because your new customers, your increased sales lie in your existing customer base. Plan or participate in an event in your community. Look in your newspapers. Go to your local libraries. Look on the bulletin board. Find some events where you can participate and show your Avon business. Complete a fundraiser every quarter. If you've not done a fundraiser this year, we're approaching the end of March. That's the first quarter of this year. So you really want to think about, where can you do a fundraiser? What organization can you help? Try a book party. Every campaign to a campaign. Once you learn how to do a book party efficiently, you're going to love it. And it's going to be the way that you're going to grow your business. Register for RepFest. The deadline is coming really close. And if you like to read for the month of March, we are reading Outliers by Malcolm Gladwell. If you've got any questions or what is your biggest takeaway from today's call, please type that in the chat. And I'm going to take the phones off of mute. If you'd like to share with us what your biggest takeaway was from today's meeting, we would absolutely love to hear from you. So all calls have been unmuted. We can hear you, and we'd love to hear your comments or suggestions as to what you might want us to cover on our next call in April.
Audriana just said she'd like to know a little bit more about how to do fundraiser.
Okay, awesome, awesome. We can incorporate that in our next call in April. If we don't cover it here, what district is Audriana in?
I got her.
Okay.
Also, maybe events, because of spring coming up, there's going to be a lot of events and what they can do to do during events if they've never done one before.
Gotcha. That's a good point. Events and fundraisers, because there's all different ways to do events. There's a way to do events with product. There's a way to do events without product. There's a ways to do events with brochures. There's a ways to do events with zero brochures. So awesome. I think those are two great suggestions. Anything else? All right. Well, if there's not any additional questions, we hope that you've enjoyed our time together. And that the information that we've covered has been helpful to your business. And we hope this has been one of the happiest hours of your day. See you later.
Bye, everybody.
Bye. Too bad.